Gonna do more on factoring trinomials and solving them. You ready, class?
Yeah!
Yay math?
Yay math!
When I say math, you say yay? Yeah. Math!
Yay!
Math!
Yay!
When I say yay, you say math! Yay!
Math!
Yay!
Math!
Okay. In case anyone at home is wondering, this is my student's jacket, so I don't blend in with the back. Now I'm a floating head. No, I'm not. Okay. Does it look okay? Yay, math. All right, so yeah, we're disrupting other class. Shh, psych. Okay, here we go. 7x squared plus 29x plus 4 equals 0. All right, question already. Love it. Go.
What is a trinomial?
Trinomial. What is a trinomial? Good. Trinomial is a polynomial, which is an equation, with three terms. One,
okay.
Two, three.
And then a polynomial
is a many-termed equation.
Okay. So a trinomial is a type of polynomial.
A trinomial is a type of polynomial. Okay. Excellent. And we just heard someone said, I'm taking notes. That's fantastic.
That was me.
That's great. I'm happy you said that. Okay. So, first things first. Is there a greatest common factor?
No.
There's no greatest common factor, so we can start our factoring process. All right, so if we were to do the foiling process, f times f, what times what is 7x squared?
7 on
that
side.
So say, yeah, go ahead.
So then, and then x and x on each side, and each thing, right?
So what times what is 7x squared? Yes?
Would it be 7x and then x?
7x and x. Is that clear? 7x and x. All right. 7x and x. Good. So we started with that one. Now we're going to go to this one. What times what is 4? What do you think? Yeah?
2 times 2.
Or
2 and 2. Or 4 and 1.
Or 4 and 1. What do you want to start with?
Let's try 2 and 2.
Let's try 2 and 2. We got 2 and 2. All right. So let's foil this dude. If we were to foil to check, forget about the signs for now,
okay.
Even though we can tell it'll be both positive. So 7x squared, right?
Uh-huh.
7x squared. 7x times 2 is?
14x.
2x, 4. Can these somehow add to make 29?
No.
So is it 2 and 2?
No.
Let's try 4 and 1. It's like a game show. Let's try 4 and 1. Okay. Where do you want to put the 4?
4.
What do you think?
Oh,
where do you think? Can you tell where you want to put the 4? Yeah, yeah.
In that one, the second one.
The second one. Interesting that you should say that.
Why?
Can you put in your own words why it'd be good to put the 4 here and not here?
Because
I love that moment. Oh! Okay, no, go ahead.
Okay. So you have to in the L. You have to do the 4 times the 7x,
which
it would be 28x.
28, yeah.
And then plus the 1, 29.
Exactly.
Yes.
Exactly. Were you going to say that, the O sayer? Was that your intention?
Yeah, it was.
Okay, good. All right, so let's make a plus plus. Foil to check. 7x squared, 28x, x. Makes 29x and 4. Yes.
Okay, so the reason why you put the 4 in the second parentheses was because it's bigger and so like it multiplies into
with the 7.
Yeah.
It'll multiply with the 7 and that will make 28 and all we need is one more to make 29.
If you put it in the first parentheses, then it wouldn't be multiplied by the 7.
Right. If you put the 4 here, 4 would be multiplied by x. And 1 would be multiplied by 7x, so that would make like 11.
So usually should you put the
like
bigger...
elevator. Yeah, go ahead.
Put the bigger number in the second one.
No, it depends what the middle term is.
Okay.
This elevator's broken. Okay, so you put the bigger number wherever you need to put the bigger number. He's still laughing, that's awesome. Okay, how many factors are still here? Or how many factors
two.
Are here?
Sorry.
Two factors, it's okay. So two factors, You set each to zero to solve, because anything times zero is zero. So we're going to set the first factor to zero, which is 7x plus 1.
Wait.
I have a question.
Yes, question.
That's not the answer?
No. The answer is solve for x. We have an equals. We need to solve for x.
Okay.
This is factored, but we're not done. Solve. Okay. So we set each factor to zero. X plus 4 equals 0. I think everyone's writing. They don't see that. One person. Everyone's writing. And they look up. Oh. Okay. And, so now we solve. Here we go. Minus 1. 7x equals negative 1. Divide by 7. Bless you! X equals negative 1 over 7. Totally cool. So high pitched. How do you make those? It's like, I'm 1/16th mouse. In other words, great grandfather. Okay, so these are the two answers. Any questions? We solved both factors set to zero. Okay. All right, we're going to do three more. You ready? Ready, yaymath? Yeah. Please don't do that. Do you have the giggles? Do you really?
I can't breathe.
That's awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, we have the giggles. Okay. That's cool.
Sorry, I don't want to interrupt.
To solve. No, you're fine. All right, solve again.